Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you get to watch, learn and experience. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mangi Francis, taking you through physics from 3, and in this lesson we are going to look at the following objectives. So stay tuned and do pay attention throughout the lesson. So what are the goals of this lesson? By the end of the lesson, you'll be able to, number 1, define the term dispersion of light. You'll also be able to define the term critical angle and total internal reflection. So dispersion occurs when a prism splits the colors of white light into the spectrum. This occurs because the refractive index of the glass or perspex of the prism varies with the colors of the spectrum that makes up the white light. Violet has the greatest refractive index and therefore deviates the most. Red has the lowest and deviates the least. So for instance, in the example given here, you can see if white light falls on a prism, it is dispersed and gives us the 7 brands of colors, which we have the red, yellow, green, and this gives us the 7 colors of the rainbow, as you can see from the splitting of the white light. Then again, what is total internal reflection? Total internal reflection occurs when light is incident on a boundary between optically more or less dense substance, for example, glass to air, and the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, see for the interface. So we have defined critical angle, and we know that this is the angle in the less dense medium for which the angle of refraction is the angle of incidence is 90. So if these two conditions apply, then total internal reflection occurs. As you can see, if the light is incident at a given angle, yes, if we increase the angle of incidence, the incident ray is totally reflected internally and there is no refraction that occurs. So the critical angle therefore becomes the angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction is 90. So when this happens, there is no refraction and total internal reflection takes place. So critical angle, once again, this is the angle in the incidence in the denser medium that results in an angle of refraction of 90 degrees. Therefore the refractive index is given by 1 all over sine c, which is the critical angle, where n is the refractive index of the denser medium. For instance, in this case we have glass is as an example in the opposite example, and c is the critical angle. So as you can see from the illustration, the critical angle of the glass is given by it is the angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction is 90. So beyond this angle, total internal reflection takes place. As you can see, the angle of refraction is 90. So let's see whether we can solve questions regarding critical angle. Calculate the critical angle of a glass to air if the refractive index of glass is 1.5. So n is given by 1 over sine c. 1 divided by the sine of 15 is, which is 0.67, and therefore the critical angle is the sine inverse of angle c, which is 42 degrees. Now let's try to answer the following question to see whether we have understood. Calculate the critical angle of water to air if the refractive index of glass is 1.3. Now you can refer this to Secondary Physics Students Book 3, or give us a tweet or a text message through the numbers on your screen, or visit us through our YouTube channel or Facebook page at Elimu TV. Once again, I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi. Stay tuned for more lessons to come.